those folks.
Yeah.
In the church.
Yeah.
We know how to act.
Huh? Yeah.
Yeah.
We know how to act humble. The Lord didn't say act humble and I will exalt you. He said humble yourself. He that humbleth himself shall be exalted. He that exalteth himself shall be abased.
Amen.
Stop always looking at your own stuff. Learn the blessed benefit of looking also on the things of others. Days gone by, criminals had a rough time. Nobody was jealous of anybody else.
Amen.
So they didn't lock their doors in the room.
Amen.
They did not hook the screen door.
Amen.
So folk could just walk in. Wish you had a witness. But if they saw you coming out with something you did not bring in, they'd stop you. Used to watch how men acted around little girls. Around little girls that were not there. Y'all don't like me. Oh, if we would start again looking sometimes on the things of others with an eye of protection or an eye of detection, many of our children would not be molested. Our children are in trouble. Vulnerable little creatures. Some old person will act like they really love them. And the child doesn't need what they want to give them. You need to stop encouraging our young women to sow your wild oats. You don't need to grow any wild oats. Them oats will make you sing.
You need to spend some so you mild oats, child. You don't have to be sitting up in the church all the time.
Them oats that will make you sing. I wish I had me a witness. I'm gonna say it again. Them oats, them wild oats, are the ones that'll make you sing. The word of the Lord says, look on the things of others. They saw you making an error in the church where I grew up. They didn't tell everybody. They weren't whispering about your business. They talked to you. I saw you're married, ain't you? Aren't you married? I saw how you was talking to that sister over there. Watch it, brother. Y'all like me. I'm gonna say it again. Aren't you married, honey? I saw you flirting with that brothers over there. Don't do that, honey. The word will get out on you. They're going to call you a sickle and a rake. But they'll have some garden food for you. Brothers and sisters, y'all don't like me enough. Says the Christ has the right mind. Oh, have mercy. He has the right mind. And the mind of Christ is an emptying mind. He emptied himself of what he looked like to the angelic host. Amen. Somebody said he took off his royal robe. A seamless robe. Took off, my brothers and sisters, his heavenly glory. far some flesh without a spot or blemish.
Yeah.
He is the one who, being in the form of God, thought it not robbery to be equal with God, but made himself of no reputation, and took upon him the form of a servant, and made himself in the likeness of man, being found in the fashion as a man. He humbled himself. See, the most humble man to ever walk this ground is Jesus, the Christ. He did not come calling on men to bow down to him. Lord help us. Of him we could easily say he would not bruise a broken reed, nor would he quench a smoking flax. And because he humbled himself, because he did not exalt himself, but became obedient unto death, even the death of the cross. I heard how God responded to his humility. And I want to tell you tonight that because he humbled himself and became obedient unto death, that God the Father highly exalted him and gave him a name that's above every name. I tell you tonight, if you will humble yourself, exalt myself, I got to build my own life. If I'm trying to exalt myself, I have to make my own garments. Lord have mercy. If I'm trying to exalt myself, I got to give my body a certain amount of exercise so I look muscular and look mighty fine. But if God exalts me, he'll put a wonder in my face.